got to win the game to the people who run it, to the people who own it, that unless you're free, the machine will be prevented from working at all, from working at all, from working at all.
Don't lay down and die because a new world order, the business of the day for the elite, when you're coming to take your freedoms.
Hello again, human beings from the planet Earth, and happy Sunday. It's craziness. I'm stumbling from words. I'm still not awake, and I'm reading this post in the Pack Alert Press. Headline reads, DHS prepares for civil unrest as Obama poised to destroy the Second Amendment. We all know about the recent deal with the UN and wanting to take our guns and all that, and then he's asked for an extension. Let me caution you. He's just appeasing the gun owners so he can get the gun owners' votes. He raised a ruckus to draw attention to himself. And now he's going to appease the gun owners for a short time. And you can bet after he gets his ass back in office in November, because the sheep will put him back in and they have no other choice because Romney sucks as bad or worse. And so there you are. Here you are in a box with no escape. But anyway, he will go ahead and start taking your guns. Anyway, I'm going to read from this post. Surveillance drones have a new mission according to the Department of Homeland Security. They will be used for public safety. Janet Napolitano, Secretary of the DHS, told a House committee meeting on Homeland Security that more than 30,000 drones that will be deployed into American skies are just arbitrarily watching out for U.S. citizens, because we're all in danger, of course. Back to the post. Napolitano stated, with respect to science and technology that dictate what we do have a funded project. I think it's in California. She thinks it's in California. Are you telling me she doesn't know? Okay, what kind of a statement is that? Secretary of Department of Homeland Security, and she makes a statement, we do have a funded project, I think. It's in California. These are your leaders. Let me tell you something. I don't want your thoughts. I want proof. I want truth. I want action. I don't want your bullshit. Anyway, I'll try not to rant while I'm reading to you. Looking at drones that could be utilized to give us situational awareness in a large public safety matter or disaster, such as a forest fire, and how you could give us better information. Secretly, DHS has been taking a bid for contractors who can install aerial remote sensing, which uses light detection and ranging, or LIDAR, that would be part of the unmanned drone mission within domestic U.S. territory. DHS believes these airborne images are essential for homeland defense missions, such as planning for national special security events, Super Bowls, or national political conventions. Enhancing border, port, and airport security, as well as performing critical infrastructure inventories and assessments, has spent over $50 million to employ contractors as well as processors for images and dissemination throughout the DHS. Coincidentally, the Federal Protective Service has been given the responsibility to protecting federally owned property while preparing for civilian-led riots expected in the near future. You hear that? Preparing for civilian-led riots expected in the near future. Part of the preparatory measure was an order of 150 sets of riot gear that was requested to be filled exponentially within 15 days. 147 upper body and shoulder protection, which are brand name or equal to Centurion Soft Shell Riot Control System. 152 thigh groin protector, brand name or equivalent to Centurion TPX 200, 156 forearm protectors with brand name or equivalent to Centurion, 147 units of hard shell shin guards, 147 carry bags, 147 riot helmets. Okay, so they got a list of things they want. They know the people have had enough. The FPS is anticipating that policy or military wearing the gear would encounter blunt force trauma to the upper torso, as well as potential beatings with blunt objects. To complement these outfits are required riot helmets with tactical face shield equipped with liquid seals. In addition, the U.S. military are ready to assist with local law enforcement if called upon. Well, there goes another one of our rights and laws. 500 military police dogs will be allocated on civilian matters, as reported by mainstream media, or MSN. And this might be a heads-up to the Occupy movement. Carry a dog whistle with you. That may help in distracting these beasts that they're going to set free to bite you and take you down because they don't have enough balls to do it themselves. Anyway, back to the post. Included the reallocation of hundreds of military police officers being trained to assist local authorities in investigation, crime scenes, and case building. These same soldiers were just stationed in combat areas like Afghanistan. Like I said a while ago, they're going to bring military men who've been tormented by war and probably under the influence of drugs and use them here in the homeland now to police things. Okay, this that makes me feel a lot safer. Meanwhile, the TSA has been patrolling train stations and bus terminals in California. Now, why all of a sudden California? Well, I'm going to tell you why. Because California is overdue for a large event, and they've got a Fukushima sitting on their shores with their nuke plants out there, and there's already been reports that eyes are on that plant as it being the next Fukushima. And when a reactor blows up here in the homeland, a lot of people are going to lose their fucking minds. Instead of doing something about it now, they're going to wait until it blows up, and then they're going to lose their fucking minds, okay? And it's going to couple with all the other protests and everything else that's going on. So California, that's probably why they're starting there. Everybody's eyes are on New York, but I would be looking at the West Coast if it were me. Anyway, back to the post. According to one whistleblower, we are doing patrols in the parking lot with dogs. We're even going as far out to train station because the train station is connected to the airport here. And we have guys walking around the train station, walking around the rental cars. We're inspecting cars coming into the parking garage. I mean, we've fully expanded. We're no longer just at the gate and just at the security checkpoint. The preparations at DHS and FPS are making for civil unrest may be tied to Article 15 of the UN's Arm Treaty. This part allows foreign troops, preferably NATO forces, to offer assistance in implementing the ATT, as the ATT does not specify adherence to the Second Amendment, but rather make vague definitions of who can own a gun, what type of gun, and for what purpose. The constitutional rights we take for granted now will be stripped from us once the ATT is signed. To downplay the severity of our American right to bear arms against tyrannical dictators and foreign domestic, President Obama stated at a National Urban League meeting that we recognize the traditions of gun ownership that passed on from generation to generation, that hunting and shooting are part of the cherished national heritage. I also believe there's a lot of gun owners would agree that AK-47s belong in the hands of soldiers, not in the hands of criminals. That they belong on the battlefield of war, not in the streets of our cities. Okay, little commentary. A gun does not make a criminal. A criminal is a criminal. Doesn't matter what type of gun. So when they automatically label somebody that's carrying an AK-47 as a criminal, okay, so what, you have to take away all guns, or criminals only use AK-47s, so you can't have them? What type of bullshit is that? Are you going to listen to that? Okay, back to the post. Richard Charade, attorney and member of the Libertarian National Committee, commented on the Second Amendment. The Second Amendment was to protect the ability of the people to violently overthrow the government. Let's remember that this country was formed in a violent revolution. Let's remember at Lexington and Concord, citizens fired on and killed government soldiers set by the central government to confiscate their weapons and arms. When viewed in this light, it is apparent that a limitation of an automatic weapon would be an infringement on the purpose of the Second Amendment. Wayne Lapierre, vice president of the NRA, has called out Obama as being part of a conspiracy to ensure re-election by lulling gun owners to sleep. All that first-term lip service to gun owners is just part of a massive Obama conspiracy to deceive voters and hide his true intentions to destroy the Second Amendment during his second term. Lapierre states that upon re-election, Obama would be busy dismantling and destroying our firearms freedoms, erase the Second Amendment from the Bill of Rights, and exercise it from the U.S. Constitution. Okay, that's the post. And one more comment, going back to the AK-47 deal. You know, Some people drive a fucking Cadillac. Some people drive a Honda. Those are our choices here in America. You have the freedom to do what you want. You have to live within your means. Maybe somebody can only afford a shotgun. He should have that right. Maybe someone else can own an AK-47. I personally don't need one. But I don't want to limit anybody else's right to have one. Now that's up to that individual to live within the means of the law, and not go around spraying people with bullets, okay? Now listen, if somebody wants to kill massive amounts of people, they don't need an AK-47 to do that. Just ask the government. All you have to do is fly a plane into a tall building. Good Lord.